Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Before we listen, you know, during the lunch break, there was something very special that happened about our precious sister. She was sharing a testimony of her son. Son, right?
Yeah.
How old is your son?
13.
So he was 11 when he met me. Okay, he had got white patches on his knuckles, on the top of his hand, on both his hands, and he had come with these white patches. And at that time, I spoke to them that, you know, there's a scripture in the Bible of a man named Naaman who had leprosy in 2 Kings chapter 5, and how Elisha told him to go and dip himself in the river Jordan, and it looked extremely easy, and Naaman was very angry because he did not want to do it. But the servant of Naaman told him, if the man of God had given you something difficult, you would have done. So why don't you go and just do it, because he tells you to do it. So Naaman was a commander of the Syrian army. Taking the instruction of Elisha, goes to the river Jordan, dips himself 7 times, and when he gets out, his skin has become absolutely normal and he is completely healed of leprosy. So I told his mother, every day when your son goes to a bath, you do the same and tell yourself and tell your son to tell that I'm not really dipping myself in the river Jordan, but I'm dipping myself in the blood of Jesus. If the waters of Jordan could heal, how much more the blood of Jesus? And today I met her after a long time, and she said, you know, 2 years back, my son had this patch, and we began to do it every day. And also when he is not taking bath, by saying that the blood of Jesus has cleansed his skin. And how long it took to get this healing?
3 months, 4 months.
In 3 to 4 months, the skin was absolutely normal. Praise God. And today this sister came, and she has been suffering from 2 years as well. But that time you did not tell me that you were suffering. Or that time you were not suffering.
It was not much.
Much. But after that she had been suffering with constant headache as if somebody is knocking on her head. And through that she is getting numbness in her toes and all that. She has done an MRI and she came here. And during the lunch break she just spoke this. That, you know, I'm going through this. And I asked her, according to Isaiah 61 verse 3, it says that when we wear the garment of praise, say that garment.
Garment
of praise. So he's not saying when we praise God, but he's saying when we wear the garment of praise. What does that mean? Whether I'm in good mood or a bad mood, nobody will remain without clothes. We will cover our body, right? In the same way, whether I'm in good mood or bad mood, I just as I cover my body, in the same way, I will praise my God. So when the person praises God, okay, the Bible says the spirit of heaviness shall depart. And I asked her, do you believe that? She said, yes. And we began to pray and I said, just keep saying hallelujah. And I said, now believe that when you are saying hallelujah, there is a war that is going on and the spirit of heaviness that is the cause of this sickness shall be destroyed. She hardly said it for 3 minutes and she began to become breathless. And 2 months back I met one other young baby who was crying, depressed, 2 months back. In 2 months God has turned the mourning into dancing. And I called her and I said, just take your hand and put that hand on her chest. She hardly touched. We all saw what happened. The sister was completely set free. Now there's no headache. No numbness? It's gone. So MRI cancelled. Praise God. Hallelujah. Why I'm sharing this testimony is because of what we learned in the morning. What did we learn in the morning? T?
Trust.
No, T. Don't look at the notes. Come on. What did we? Thinking on?
Thinking
on God's word. Now what was happening to this mother? She was thinking on the skin of her son. When she came here, she was thinking on the knocking in her head, praise God, all that I had to do was to make her think no longer on situations and circumstances, but on the scriptures. Praise God.
Yes.
And that is what Mother Mary did, that when the angel spoke to her, she kept thinking on God's word. And just as they started thinking on God's word produced the result. Praise God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So if there is anybody who is going through the white patches in your skin, the same anointing that healed her son of the skin infection or any kind of skin infection going on in your life, in the name of Jesus, you also believe. And especially when you take bath, keep saying, Lord, I am having bath with your precious blood, and there is life in your blood, there is victory in your blood. And as your blood flows over my skin, over my body, your precious blood has destroyed every work of Satan, every sickness has been destroyed, and I've received a brand new skin. Now when you say these words, these are God's words, you're thinking on it, you're believing it, you're acting on it, now these words will bring forth the manifestation of God's glory. Thank you and praise you, Father, for these great testimonies. And all those who are suffering from migraine, open your mouth and praise God. The Bible says in Isaiah 61:3 that when you open your mouth and praise God with confidence, with assurance, that words of praise coming out of your mouth destroys the spirit of infirmity, destroys the spirit of heaviness, and that migraine will be completely gone, never to come back again, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. So we learned the first point, trust, that is she was thinking on God's word. Now let's go to the next point. What is that? R. Recognizing God's will. Praise God. So what was God's will for Mother Mary's life? That was in Luke chapter 1, 31 to 33. And behold, now this is what God is sharing through the angel Gabriel to Mother Mary, his plan and his will for her life. Praise God.
Yes.
Have you heard this word, God's will?
Yes.
How will I know what is God's will for my life? Now let me give you an example. There was a mother and a father who had a big property, and they had three children. So what will the father do before his death? He'll make a will. What's the spelling of that will? W-H-E-E-L. Very good.
W-I-L-L.
Not W-H-E-E-L?
No.
W-I-L-L. Okay. Now, even though it is called a will or a document, is it opened and shared before his death or after his death? So what is the meaning? He puts in a document whatever he desires, that after his death, even though he is not present physically, his words will make the distribution of the property. Right?
Yes.
So the document is opened only after his death. And whatever he had desired in his heart, he has mentioned it in words, and according to those words, the order will be executed. Is it right? In the same way, Jesus, before leaving this planet earth, praise God, has for us his words, which are now documented by the apostles, and that is his document which we are opening and reading, and it speaks about his desire for us. So how will I know what is God's will for my life? I know God's will for my life when I know his word. So his word is God's will for my life. Praise God.
Praise God.
Example. Is his will saying love one another?
Yes.
Love your enemies?
Yes.
Do good to those who?
Yes.
Submit to your husband?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, are those words speaking about God's will?
Yes.
Yes. But when you are going to do it, is it going to be easy?
No.
No. It's going to make you uncomfortable. But is it God's will? Yes. In the same way for Mother Mary, God is giving her His will, and He mentioned it in the Word. What does He say? Behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bring forth a son and shall call His name Jesus. Was that God's will? Yes. He shall be great. Is it God's will?
Yes.
And shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom shall, there shall be no end. Now, this is what God has told Mother Mary through the angel Gabriel. Now, she has been treasuring this word for the last 33 years. Okay, this is before the conception. Now, in her lifetime, did she see it manifest?
Yes.
Come on, did she see it manifest?
Yes.
Never.
No.
Instead of he sitting on the throne, he was stuck on the cross.
Yes.
Instead of getting a crown, he got a crown of thorns. Instead of he being called the Son of God, he was called a criminal. Hello?
Yes.
What else is there? Let's see. Instead of he being made great, he looked a victim on the cross. Hallelujah. His kingdom shall never end. He is dying at the age of 33. Now she had treasured everything in her heart. Okay? But what she treasured and what she thought and what God had said, did it look manifesting? No. So what should be the scream of a, what should be a cry? God, you promised me all these things, but what I see is no evidence of those things. I see exactly opposite. So God, did you tell me a lie? Let's say you are the mother and you see exactly what God has said and what you see on the cross, is it matching? So what will be the thought coming into your mind? Did God tell me a lie? How did she fight that battle? And how do you think she must have fought that battle? Pondering only the word of God, it looks a lie. Isn't it looking a lie?
Yes.
Where's the crown? Crown of gold and diamonds. Where's the son being made great? He's called a criminal. How did she believe? Put that verse 31, please. How did she believe? How did she believe? Did she conceive a son?
Yes.
Without a human father?
Yes.
Did the first part get fulfilled?
Yes.
So she's saying, I don't care, Lord. But the most important of all, he coming into my womb without a physical relationship with a man, which is impossible to the impossible. If that was fulfilled, I don't know about other things, but if that was fulfilled, then I can continue to believe the other things also will be fulfilled, even though I don't understand it now. I don't understand. But if you have said it, it will be done. Because you said it, I agreed with it, and it was done. So the other things, even though it doesn't look like at the moment, still it will be done by you in the future. And that's where we get deceived. When we believe in something that God has promised us, we want all the physical evidence and everything to look exactly what he has said. And if it doesn't happen the way he has said, then we quickly jump to a conclusion that it's not happening. Now let's take an example. Joseph, God said, I'm going to make you great. And what is the physical evidence that you see? Sold as a slave? What great man? In the prison? What great? So God's ways of fulfilling the prophecy is entirely different from our way of thinking. When Joseph was in the prison, do you think that this man will ever come out of the prison? But ultimately, did he become the governor of Egypt?
Yes.
So what is God saying? When he gives you a promise, you are thinking on God's word, you will now begin to recognize his will. But before his will can be manifested, all through the process, you might not understand. Just because you don't understand does not mean it will not come to pass. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And where do we go wrong? We go wrong when we don't understand and there's no evidence to prove in our favor. We open our mouth and prophesy exactly opposite to God's word. And that's the time we have blown up God's purpose and plan, which was growing. It is like a farmer who grew the crop, waited and said, I can't see any crop. Okay, let's say a person planted mango tree. The tree is growing and the fruit is supposed to come after 5 years. 4 years he waited. No fruit. He's angry. He goes and cuts off the tree. If it's a coconut tree, 7 years, no fruit. He waited for 6 years, no fruit. Cuts off the coconut tree. How many trees have we cut? Because we did not see the fruit. We did not see the evidence. We saw only leaves. We did not see the fruit. What is our desire? Leaves or fruit? Praise God. Are we understanding? So what was she doing? She was recognizing God's will. Don't make noise. Hallelujah.
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 So even though God had spoken to her the truths and prophecies, and they did not look to seem to come true, did she freak out? Was she impatient? Was she angry? But in spite of all that, she had extreme patience and she continued to ponder on those truths. And because she kept on pondering on those truths, she began to recognize God's will. Praise God.
Praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Now in today's morning song, Mary, did you know? Did she know everything?
No.
What? Did she know everything?
No.
So many a times we begin to ponder, because I don't know everything, how will I know God's will? Listen, to know God's will, you don't need to know all things. She knew the first part, to agree to God's word and continue to agree to God's word. And the more and more you agree by being a doer of the word, that's the time you will begin to recognize God's will. I'll tell you honestly, in my life also, I did not know that God is going to use me all around, going around and all those things. I was only being a doer of the word. I was only going around sharing my testimony. I was going around looking for opportunities where I could be used by God for his kingdom. And more I thought about it, praise God, the more and more it opened up. Now when I came in 2008, sister, did you think I would be coming every month? I never knew. But as I began to do, then I began to understand. Gary boy, did you ever think that when I met you, at that time you all were not doing all these things, right? Did you ever think that you would be doing the editing, uploading, and camera, and all those things that what you are doing now? You got into the word. You know, once it so happened, let me share with you. I started having a radio channel. And at that time, I had a conference, Skype, about 100-150 people who are listening to the radio. And they would hear it live. I would be speaking live. And they would send the messages on Skype. So if somebody would send a message, then I would read it on the radio. And it was like this going on. And one fine day, somebody sent a message, I'm going through some problem in my marriage. So, you know, it was a conference. So one person thought, okay, let me help him. So he went and into a private chat and began to talk to him and began to tell him, see, listen, you got to do this, you got to do this, you got to do this. After 3 weeks, he sent back the message. They were in chat every day. After 3 weeks, the chat came, you know, everything got solved. Marriage is good, everything is good. And now came the introduction after 3 weeks. What do you do? And this person writes and says, today was the first day of the school. I went to school. Okay, which subjects do you teach? I don't teach. I'm in standard 8th. What did you say?
8th.
And the man said, you are counseling me for my marriage and my marriage got restored and you are saying that you are studying in standard 8th? Now, how can this boy of standard 8 give counseling for a person whose marriage is in crisis? You know how? He recognized God's word. He's thinking on God's word, on what he heard. He's recognizing it and only mentioning him, according to God's word, you do this and this and this. How it's going to be solved? Does he know?
No.
Does he know?
No.
No. This is what God has said. Just do that much. God will show you how he is going to do it. Praise God. He got a shock of his life. He calls me up and he says, can you believe there's a boy in Kuwait studying in standard 8th and he counseled me and my marriage got restored? I said, is that boy's name Gary Boy? He said, how do you know? I said, I know because he is soaked in the word of God. Who else would be that he would give you counseling to save your marriage? Now what about the other person? He never knew the word. Today that same person is having his own Bible classes. So the seed that you planted, Gary Boy, has grown up so much. Now, did you ever think that you would be doing this, Baba? No. How did it happen? Before we could have this, you all were already in the word, sister?
No.
Nothing at all?
No, nothing.
So, first, thinking on God's word. Once you start thinking on God's word, you will begin to recognize God's will. Amazing, isn't it?
Yes.
Then there was another person from Sri Lanka. He was about 65, 70 years old. His children were going through in UK. You remember that? You must be not remembering. So many people he was chatting. And when I went to Sri Lanka, he was saying, you know, my children were going through some situation. And this is a very nice man in Kuwait. You know, always when I put a message, he will always reply to me. And I would send the message to my children. Same time, okay? And, wonderful man. I said, what is his ID, Gary? He said, yeah, how do you know? I said that tomorrow, no, when you send the message, ask him, my dear friend, tell me how old are you? And then you tell me, what is he saying? And he writes there, I am only 12 years or 13 years old. That man is holding his head. And he said, I never knew that I was chatting with a boy of 13 years old. What's the Lord showing? It's not the age. It's how much you think on God's word. And that will what will open God's will. Did you ever think you would be going to US, Baba?
No.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
So don't ever think that you will know God's will to the very point, to point, to point. No. As long as we are living on this planet Earth, we live by faith and not evidenced by our senses. It is only when we get up there, we will know everything in the open, because there everything will be open to us. But here, we are living in a shadow. So many people are not ready to step out in faith because they are saying, let God give me the whole story of His will, then I will go and do it. Praise God. God is talking to you loud and clear. And that's what Jesus wants to, that's what God wants to show us. Mary did not have the whole story. She did not have. She had only step number one. And based on what was said, she treasured that and made that as the root. And on that, she was all the time in obedience. And that's how she went through. Praise God. That's why you don't find her anywhere hindering God's plan or hindering Jesus from doing God's will. Because she realized one thing. God has given me this son who is supposed to accomplish God's will, not my will. God has given this child to me who is supposed to die for His people. But she never knew that He is supposed to die in this way. Praise God.
Praise God.
Write down. Mary pondered the word which she was told and began to recognize God's will and began to recognize God's will. There are many times there are many times we often get caught up with the mindset that if I don't understand everything about what God has said, then I can't know His will. We can know God's will. Even if we don't understand everything that He tells us in His word. He tells us everything in His word. We will never know the full scope. We'll never know the full scope of God's will until we get into heaven. Until we get to heaven. Praise God. Have you seen sometimes the mothers who get pregnant, they are set with the two needles, cut.
Yes.
And they start making with the yarn, woolen yarn, different sweater and all. Now, when you see those two needles and you see the bundle of yarns of different colors, can you see anything? But only when the mother takes it in a hand and starts working on it, it turns into a beautiful sweater. Correct? In the same way, the word of God is the needle and the yarn just lying down there. It is only when you take that needle and that yarn and start working on it by doing what the instruction says, now the sweater is ready. So most of the time, what do we want? We want to tell God, don't give me the needle and the thread, give me the sweater. Did God give Mother Mary the needle and the thread, or did he give her the sweater? But by the end of her life, was she fruitful?
Yes.
That she made a beautiful sweater out of those needle and thread?
Yes.
Yes. How? But did she know the plan? No. One stroke at a time, every day. Praise God. Did it turn into a beautiful God's purpose?
Yes.
In the same way, it's happening in our life. But even though the needle and the thread is there, and instead of doing it God's way, we do it the world's way. Now, will it get delayed? Hello, will it get delayed? Yes. Because my sister was saying, yes, the last time some people had come from India, and they were going to one place, and Brother Paul missed that lane. So to get to that place, they had to go all the way around and come back and then get to over there. And she said it took us more than 1 hour, which would have taken 5 minutes or 10 minutes.
Yes.
Now, because you missed the mark, doesn't mean the plan has failed. But because you missed the mark, some of the resources will go wasted. Time got wasted, energy got wasted, petrol got wasted, KD went.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. So there will always be a difference, God's perspective and man's perspective. God is a master planner. He will use even the negative things, mostly even the most negative things, he'll use to get his perfect plan manifested. But the question is, am I going to be anxious, in worry, or am I willing to depend on God and step out in faith to carry out his instructions? Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'll give you an incident that comes to my mind. There was this brother who told us, let's go to my cousin's house. This cousin of mine has got no job. He was working in the Gulf for the last 4 years. He's been in India trying to get a job to go back to the Gulf, but not getting any job. So if this person is staying more than 4 or 5 years, okay, if this person has been staying in India and not working for 5 years, whatever he has saved, will that start getting will he start using that?
Yes.
Yes. So he was doing the same, and his resources were coming lower and lower and lower, and now he had begun to sell some of the things what he had brought from abroad so that he could get some money and run the house. So when we went home to his place, I saw that most of the things were already gone. Okay? And looking at the condition of the house and what was told to me, I knew that these people would have had extreme difficulty to even serve tea and coffee and some biscuits. Okay? They served that. They served the biscuits and all. And I heard the Lord saying to me, I want you to empty the purse and give everything to them. Now it was in Vasai. Okay? and it was away from the station. So I am telling God, at least let me keep the rickshaw money. I am ready to empty my purse and give it to him. And thank God, in India one thing is good in Bombay. When you buy a train ticket, you buy a return ticket as well. Otherwise I would have had to come walking from Vasai. Okay. So I gave him and he was shocked and he said, no. I said, no, yes. It went on. And he said, at least take the rickshaw money because it's about 6 kilometers from the station. So I said, no, God told me to give it to you. I'm giving it to you. I don't know. And I came down and I'm all excited, okay, because I've obeyed. Now what is my plan? My plan is, God, I obeyed you, so you are surely going to give me a lift. Am I thinking wrong? No. So I'm walking, showing this way. What? This way, I reached the station. Walking! And I'm saying, God, sometimes I don't understand, why did you make me walk? I don't know. And thank God, I said, God, one thing was good that I bought a return ticket, otherwise you would have made me walk from Naigaon to Dahisar. So somehow I reached home, did not understand, gave up, had given them the homework. After 3 months, I was in a night vigil and I saw that man's wife in the night vigil. Okay, I recognized her. So she recognized me and she came to meet me. And she started weeping. I said, what happened? She said, what you told us, we did. And in 1 month time, all of a sudden my husband got a job. But he got a job in a country where the company says, out of 5 people, 4 people have got HIV. Okay, that particular place. So they want people to work over there, but the condition is, from the airport, the company will come and pick you up and take you in, do your medical, take you in. Then you can't come out of that boundary till they send you back home. So you can't come out at all. It's a huge company. Everything is taken care of, your house, your food, everything. But there's no way you can come out. Second, the money is not given in your hand. It is transferred straight to your account. You can't use the money there. Okay? And my husband, out of desperation, he said, doesn't matter, I'll go. And he's gone there and he sent me up and he called me and said, it is the best place, everything is provided. And the best part, I don't even have to spend a single rupee. Everything is saved. And they take total precaution that no infection, nobody in the company is infected. So it's extremely safe. And when I work overtime, they give me double the salary. And because they have got less people, I'm working overtime. So that means in a month, I'm getting every day overtime. And I'm extremely happy and I want to thank God that God gave me the best job. Now, he was there and he had a very good salary, very huge salary. Now, did I think when I went to his house 1 or 3 months back that this man has got no money to give me coffee and biscuits? And in 3 months' time, his salary would be more than 2 lakhs. Overtime extra. Okay? Now how did God do it? When he got this job, there was desperation. That's why he said, okay, I'm ready to go. Now how many of us would want to take a job where there is HIV around? But because of the condition, he said, okay. But when he went there, he said, I'm living in a palace. Everything is taken care of. Because of that fear, nobody is allowed to get inside the compound or anybody to go outside the compound. So God's way of blessing you is beyond imagination. So what he lost a job for 5 years, God in no time can give him the recovery of all that in 1 year time. In 1 year he has earned for 5 years. Are you following what I'm saying? So many a times we don't understand why God makes us do things. And you know, when I planted that seed, I was telling him, I have seen all those who are not in debts, okay? You must take even your 1 KD or 2 KD and find people who are in debts and give it to them and make a prayer and say, God, this is the anointing of prosperity. I'm not in debts. Let this seed destroy the curse of lack, the curse of debts, the curse of poverty in this person's life. And you make that prayer. Now you know what happens? This seed starts destroying that lack in that person's life. I've seen it doing it. I do it and I've seen result in it. How it's going to happen, I still don't know. Will it happen? I know it happens. So I don't know how it happens, but I know it happens. Praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know, you know, when the land was given in Goa, I had 10,000 rupees in my pocket and all 100 rupees note. And I went into that wilderness because it was like a jungle. And I stood there taking that 10,000 in my hand and I'm saying, God, I got 10,000 and in this 10,000, how are you going to build? I don't know. But this 10,000, I'm willing to give. And today when you come and see, you'll be amazed what God has done. Which are the people who are going to come? What it is, I don't know. But I know one thing, Lord. You'll surely do it. Are you following what I'm saying?
Yes.
We get into fear because we want to know every detail of what God is going to do. It won't come. Praise God. Look at Mother Mary. Did she know the whole detail?
No.
No. If she did not know in such a big plan, do you think you will know in your plan? In God's plan for you? But how many times are you asking God? Should be the whole plan, huh, God? And if God has to show you the whole plan, then why do you need to depend on God? You will depend on yourself. Huh? Because you don't know, now you're all the time depending on Him. Is it right?
Yes.
I like your expression, sister, who's sitting behind. No, you only. You.
Me?
Yeah. I like your expression. You know? You know what that means? You're saying, now I understand how it is.
Praise God.
Because when I was talking about God doing this in our life, having a rehab center and all, we did not have money. We did not have money to buy a max stand. Okay? So how do you think that God will do this? It is His will that His people be blessed. How He's going to do is not my job. Lord, what do you want me to do so that your plan be fulfilled? So we got to recognize God's plan. And that's what she recognized, God's plan. Praise God.